David Yeagley, great-great-grandson of Bad Eagle of the Comanches. This is Saturday afternoon, February 4th. I'm in a suit and tie because I came home from church. I was born and raised a Seventh-day Adventist, and as a matter of fact, I delivered a sermon this Sabbath morning, and that's why I'm still in my Sabbath clothes, or as my grandfather George Portillo used to call them, citizen's clothes. Citizen's clothes. I bring this up to make a point. My mother's father, George Portillo, also called Anacleto Portillo, is the grandson of Bad Eagle. It's right in between. There's five generations. I'm a fifth generation descendant. George, my grandfather, is in the middle of those generations. Born in 1895 on most records, but also some of them say 1896. The point I would like to make is on his draft registration card, which is on file in military records of 1917, so this is a World War I registration. On the one side of the card, the first side of the card, he says that for the blank, that for religion, blank, fill it in, he put Seventh-day Adventist in 1917. I'm not sure about the story. He would have been something like 22 years old at the time. But to my knowledge, there was no Adventist people in Southwest Oklahoma. I can't prove this because I've been given to understand from Adventist officials that in a fire many years ago, records were destroyed, but tracing how the Seventh-day Adventist faith came into the Bad Eagle descendants, how it came into our family, is a mystery that I am pursuing. And as I have pointed out in articles that I've written, the first mission, official mission that we know in among Comanches, at least of the Protestant church, was a Baptist church. It was a man named Deyo, D-E-Y-O, E-C Deyo. Cyrus was his middle name, I remember that. He was a Baptist minister. He started a mission there. And I don't know if he taught Comanches that Sunday was the Sabbath. But I do know that in modern times, that is after the 20s, and probably before that, the Comanches had a word for Sabbath. The word for Sabbath was Poatabi, or Poarabi, Power Day. That was the word that was used for Sunday. Whereas the word for Saturday was kapoatabe, not Sabbath. Well, that sounds like a Baptist to me. But more seriously speaking, the suggestion of the language there is curious, because Comanches had no names of specific days. That was not part of the language. Day, tabi, was the same word for sun. I mean, either the sun was shining or it wasn't. It was either night or day. They had a word for cold and hot, which we would call summer and winter. But they did not have days for months. They did not have names of days. I've looked at many, well, they're not many, but the earliest word lists. In my published article, I named three. There's actually four. But nobody has an indication that any of the days had names, except suddenly after 1910. I have one list, which is the second list, word list, and I haven't determined yet the dates on those, so I don't know how old that list is. It's 20th century, because it's on an old typewriter. The list was made with an old typewriter. The keys, you can tell it's old. Could be 1910. It could be shortly around the time that Deyo began his mission, which was in the late 1890s. But I'm trying to determine two things: how Seventh-day Adventist religion came to be known, at least by the Bad Eagle descendants, as early as 1917, where my grandfather, George Pertillo, wrote Seventh-day Adventist on his draft registration card, or somebody wrote it on there. It was written on his card. His name is on his card. It's supposedly signed by him. I have to trust this record. That's one issue, how the Adventist message came into our family. The other question is when names of days began. If naming of the days of the week began with the Deyo mission, then it looks like the old Baptist minister decided that he was going to teach them that Sunday was the Sabbath and that Saturday definitely was not the Sabbath. So the question is, were there already Comanches acknowledging the Sabbath of the Lord, Saturday, the seventh day? This is extraordinary, if true. So the phenomenological question is, why would Deyo, Pastor Deyo, distinguish those two days in the way that he did? Sunday being the poharabe, the power day, the magic day, medicine day, and specifically say that Saturday was kapoharabe, or kapohatabe. Why would he distinguish Saturday as being not Sabbath if Comanches had not already thought that it was, or that somebody had a notion that the seventh day was the Sabbath of the Lord? Of course, Saturday is the Sabbath. The seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord. That's in Genesis chapter 2. So this is curious, and I'm just thinking of this today because I am an ordained elder in the Adventist Church, and our pastor was absent today. He was out of town, and he asked me to deliver the sermon, which I did. So I was taught these things from childhood. I grew up with this knowledge, But what I'm learning now is it was in our family a long time ago, 1917, before there's any established Adventist church or network in southwestern Oklahoma. I'm still seeking the facts on that matter. But for now, I wanted to bring that point out, that Adventism has been in our Comanche family for a long time.